Is it too late to start saving for retirement? Stay tuned.
Cindy says, Cindy says, Cindy says, Cindy says,
work it out though, work it out. Nothing moves till you move, work it out. Finance looking right, work it out though. Minding your body right, work it out though.
When is a good time to start saving for retirement? Right now. I'm going to give you 9 ways to start saving for retirement, no matter what your age is. Step number 1. First of all, I know everyone on the internet knows everything and they believe YouTube University is the answer to everything. It is the answer to a lot of things, but not everything. Step 1, I would seek a financial advisor. I may get myself a little educated on the internet by using YouTube, Google, and those things. But I will also personally talk to a financial advisor. This is about your money. You may even want to leave the house and go talk to a financial advisor, or at least do a Zoom call. That would be tip number 1. Tip number 2, do an examination. What are your retirement goals? What is your retirement savings goal? If your goal is to have $1 million by the time you retire, you need to make sure you tell that advisor at that first visit what your goal is. And also prior to that visit, do your own due diligence, do your own research, and look at the tools that could possibly help you get to that $1 million. Of course, you can move a little slower if you're a little younger, if you're a little more seasoned over the age of 40, you really got to get plugging along, look and see what you have, look and see what you can do with what you have to make that money grow. I've talked about tip number 3 a few times. I cannot say it enough. If you are employed and fortunately have the, if you are employed and are fortunate enough to have an employer that does retirement contribution, you need to definitely take the opportunity and use that particular tool or resource that that employer has. If they do matching, that means what you put in, they match. That's free money, free money. I don't care if it's 1% of your check, of course do the max, sometimes that's 3, sometimes that's 5, sometimes that's 6. I would say do the max depending on what your retirement saving goals are. If they're going to give you free money, you definitely put the money in and let them give you the additional free money. I know for a fact if you do that, depending on what your income is, you can definitely have $1 million by retirement if you're starting in your 20s or 30s. I know that as a personal fact. Tip number 4, start separate funds. For example, have a fund just for emergencies. I talk about this on this channel. Actually have a tool that I use just to save for emergencies. Have an emergency fund, have a medical fund, have those things sitting to the side for the simple fact, this is how you're gonna save money. When these emergencies come up, and let's say hypothetically, you do not have that cash available, people tend to put that on a credit card. Credit cards generally have an interest rate, or you have to go get an emergency loan from your job, of course, or for your credit union or from your bank, that also charges interest, which is less money we have to put into our savings. So right out the gate, start doing a savings fund for emergencies. Start doing a savings fund for medical. There are tons of challenges out there online. You can do it with a group of people. You can do it with us here, where you can start saving for medical expenses and also for any type of emergencies. Let's say you're just lucky. You never have an emergency. You never have a savings. You never have a medical problem or where you have to expend any money. By the time you retire, that's two other different types. Those are two different other savings that you have that has been sitting there for 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. So get those medical expense savings accounts set up right now. If your company or your employer has a retirement plan that you can contribute to, put this video on hold. Go log in right now and start contributing to that retirement fund. Do the most you can do right now And then every year, increase that until it maxes out. Increase it by 1% every single year until you retire or leave that company. You're getting a raise. You're doing a good job, which is why you're going to be there. You're doing a great job. So instead of just getting the increase every year that you get and just blowing it, put it completely into that retirement plan that your job has provided for you. You didn't have the money prior to the raise, so you really shouldn't miss it. As previously discussed, a way to create money without necessarily getting a second income is trim those expenses. How do we do that? People don't want to believe it, but you can still use coupons to cut down expenses. You can get things, more things on sale. Some of the things that you're farming out are having independent contractors do, like maybe the yard and some paintings and updates in your home. Do those yourself. Decrease those expenses, trim those expenses, and take those monies and put them into a savings plan. Trim the expenses. If you are already down to the bare bones, and that happens to a lot of us at different times of our lives, take on an additional income. I'm not saying go get a second job and work 40 hours a week, but you can get another source of income, maybe a part-time job. There are a lot of work from home jobs people talk about. And if you're not really into computers and things of that nature, you don't have to do that. You can be, I have videos about this. You can just go sit with a senior once or twice a week and make additional funds. Those funds you can use to help pay down your credit card, or you can also use those funds to go on one of those savings tools, one of those saving funds that I previously talked about. Some of the different little department stores, they hire people 1 or 2 days a week. You can take those monies and put them into your medical fund, your emergency fund, or to pay down some of your creditors. I knew someone who took a part-time job at Best Buy, I don't know, at least 10 years ago. They had a full-time job, they had a contemporary job, but they wanted Best Buy's discount at that time. Did not want to use their own money. So they took the job at Best Buy, got the discount, and got the item they was trying to purchase. 10 years have gone by. They are still at Best Buy and still have their full-time job. And I had the opportunity to talk to them about it. What did you do with all that money? 10 years, you've had kids, you've had a house. They didn't spend the money. They took the money, and they took most of the money and put it into their retirement fund. The monies that you make from your second income, you were living without the money prior. Once you get over the humps and bumps and pay off some creditors and get things on track, keep that second income. Take that money and put it into one of those retirement tools so it can be making money off the interest. Get the second job. Don't necessarily use it always to go to Bali. Use that money and put it into a tool that will make money for you. Your financial advisor will properly advise you on what to do, but you can start off first by doing some research here on YouTube University and also through Google. The last and final option or opportunity I actually had to do some research on myself. I'm going to read this directly to you. It's called Consider the Catch-up Contributions Option. This is tip number 9. Life happens and things don't always work out the way we expect for them to happen. If you happen to be over the age of 50 and find your retirement account isn't as healthy as you'd like it to be, consider making catch-up contributions. The IRS allows you to invest more than the annual limit once you are within reach of retirement age. This can amount to thousands more in your retirement account annually. It's best to check with your retirement plan managing company to verify that your annual limit is based on your type of plan. So after 50, because time is a ticking away, you can put additional monies into your retirement plan above the annual allowed amount. So check with your retirement plan, your retirement management company like Fidelity, and see what the max that you can contribute in addition to every year. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel, like, and definitely comment on this video. Share with your friends and family, especially if you know somebody over 50. They need to know that they can put additional monies into their retirement plan. So when they do retire at 62 or 55, they will have more than enough money to live on. They will have more than enough money to live off of. Thank you so much for coming to my channel, Cindy Says. Until next time, let's keep earning, praying, and saving.